planet, we all breathe the same air, and we all cherish our children's future. Everyone here tonight is here because they cherish their children, their community, and their future. Is anyone here that doesn't cherish those things? Parents will move mountains to provide for their children, but unfortunately, we've been positioned at loggerheads with one another, a zero-sum game. No side loves their children more than the other, but if we continue to play this game, the other side will not stop fighting. As long as it remains one side versus the other, we will continue to have debates, we will have petitions, resolutions, and unfortunately lawsuits, and your bond will fail. In that fight, we will all lose. We lose our community, we lose each other. I remind you that our children are watching. If your neighbor sticks out his or her hand and asks for help, the lesson to teach your children is to reach over and help them. Pacific Highlands Ranch, it sounds like you're very close to getting your own school. What we really need is you for to reach over and help us keep our schools too. Thank you very much.
It was because safety is number one to every teacher, and we always think of the kids as a treasure that the parent loves as much as we love our own children, and we never forget that. And when I saw the situation, and then to think that 150 more kids could be added, which being nice, we'd add 75 cars, there's no way you can make another entrance to that school that's going to alleviate the traffic situation. But the main thing I'd like to talk about is in all those years, I had to solve a lot of schoolyard disputes. And I'm alarmed about what I see here today. And one thing that every teacher knows is that when you're settling a dispute, you're not just talking about facts, but you're talking about the feelings that are involved. And that is probably more important than the facts. And in order to get a satisfactory solution, we would always have to address the feelings. So I have to tell you that right now, it feels like closing the hills is like the bridge on the farm bill to the people on the west. We don't understand why the bridge has to be built to get the farm bill passed. And so you have to address the feelings of the people in that neighborhood and get them on your team. I have not heard anyone west of the five that was not in favor of giving the new development the school that they need. My kids went to school in the 90s, and we have always grown the heights to accommodate new developments in Carmel Valley, and then when they opened their school, the teachers would leave, the kids would leave, and we would start over again, and nobody ever had a problem with that. This is the first time I've ever heard that there's been a division between the two parts of the school district, and I'm really concerned about that, and I urge you to think about the feelings as well as the facts, because they are very, very important in unifying this district so that you'll get the support that you want from every member of the district. Thank you.
Ting Huang?
Yeah.
She'll be followed by Jesse Ferguson.
Hello everyone, my name is Ting Huang. I come from PHR East. Good evening, so thank you so much for giving me the chance to speak some something for what's my own opinions. First, I want to say, we don't need a PHR Easter school. We don't want portables. I don't want offending the two ladies here, so if they like their children to sit in portables, that's fine. I don't want my children to sit in portables. And I do believe most of the parents, you don't want to see your own children or your neighbor's children to sit in portables and fight with the rats, right?
Yes.
So we need the school, we need portables. The second I want to say, please do not delay. I understand many people talk about the need of reconsideration, many, many things. But please think about, you have your own neighbor in the school. We don't have any workable school at all. I understand you're talking about the workable safety, but please do think about us. We have many families and children have to get up at least a half an hour, and also another 35 minutes one way to school. And I also see many children, young kids, take a bicycle to school without the parents' companies. It's very dangerous for us too. And also, I took you to preserve the new school because, you know, I understand many people think about you need to pay $300 every year to support this, the new school and other maintenance. But please think about it, we are paying thousands of dollars every year. But where's our main roof? We are paying thousands of every year. I do believe our kids deserve a good school, rather than portables, or rather than to go far distance. And also, I want to say, I cannot represent the PHR East, but I don't hear anyone from us want to close the West School. And I also don't believe why we must to close, combine the two things together to close the West School and build our East School. Why we cannot just put the vote tonight to put our PHR East School first? Because we do need a school. I understand many people want to delay, and some people want to delay, but please think about, every time you want to delay, it means another 2 or 3 years at least for us to go back. And it means 2 or 3 years, and let hundreds of families and young kids have to suffer from the traffic, to suffer from the far distance school. You are talking about your kids have a neighborhood friends, but we kids don't have a school yet. Please do it today. Thank you.
And part of that trust for me is trust in the plan. I think, one of the biggest reasons we're pushing on it on our side is to wait, are we going to wait 3 or 4 years to get a new school, or are we going to have to wait 5 or 6 or 7 years to get a new school? With girls in first grade and fifth grade, for sure my fifth grader is never going to be able to walk to her elementary school. Maybe my first grader can. I appreciate a lot of the comments I've heard tonight, especially from the West Side. I've been to a few meetings, but I think tonight has been the most passionate, and I feel closer to the West now. Understanding their plight as well. I kind of feel about supporting the plan. It's for the reason of, having my kids have a neighborhood school. I was able to walk to school and, with my parents, and I can't do that with my kids. So, I'm not an expert in education and all the hard work you guys have to do, and that's why I have to trust you guys. And
job, she'll find that useful. Funding from the district-wide fund to build a new school for East PHR is not fair for everybody else in the school district. The addition of a new neighborhood should not cause a negative fiscal impact upon the existing residents. The building of a new school in new developments is always funded by the new neighborhoods, Mariners, and the builders' fee. Our school district has been expanded during the last 20 years by adding new schools in the new developments, but none of which makes the existing residents to pay for their school. California Education Code 176-20 specifically authorized school district to impose builders' fee up to 100% cost of the new school. So, as if the Delma School District, as you said, has already planned to add a new school for the East PHR, so how did the East PHR builders acquire the building permit without paying such fees? It's very unfair that the East PHR builders maximize their profit by not paying the builder's fee. So the East PHR homeowners, since they pay less than enough Merrill's to fund the new school, it's unfair to make the residents in our whole school district to cover for, the East PHR. That's very unfair. I know they said people in the East PHR are talking about such as the traffic, such as the potholes. I'm a parent of the Sage Canyon. We do have 10 potholes. Can we ask to replace our potholes?
Better education, better environment to grow up. That's why